So I'm Mike Morrow, and I'm the owner of Morrow's Yard. Morrow's Yard is basically a training facility. And it's a training facility for most sports, but mostly, mainly, softball and baseball. We do basketball lessons here. We do some golf things in here. And we do a lot of strength training, kind of conditioning things as well. We have two personal trainers. So we try to encompass a lot of that. That's what Morrow's Yard is. It's basically a training facility. I was a high school baseball player. I was a college baseball player. I played at what was Mankato State, and later is now Minnesota State. Grew up as a catcher, middle infielder, and just all those years of playing baseball and learning from some really good individuals, some great coaches. I was able to take that information. I got into coaching. I did a lot of travel coaching. I coached three different teams. I even coached at the high school. And then was able to kind of follow my boys around and watch them play. My passion continued to grow. And then this opportunity came along. And here I am. So to understand their limitations, I think, is probably the biggest thing for a parent. I'm always encouraged when a parent understands that, because many of them feel like they're in a know-it-all situation. And the minute that they can kind of let go of that for a little bit and kind of turn that over to the experts, things become a lot clearer for their kids. You know, everyone wants their kid to be and play some kind of professional sport. At least many of them do. And the reality is it's just not going to happen. So we get so caught up in, yelling at umpires because our kids didn't get a fair shot at something, just wanting them to be so good that we push it and we put pressure on them. And then there's a complete burnout at a lot of levels. So it's really important for parents to understand to give them the tools, try to give them every opportunity to get with the right kind of people, the right coaches, and then encourage them. It's a hard role to play as a parent, but it's an important role. Sports is so much more than just the sport. They're just opportunities to take every situation and learn from it and relate it to real life situations. For me, anybody can be a good human being when things are going well. It's when things go rough, then who are you? And in sports, things go rough a lot. You don't always win. And when you don't win, who are you? How do you get better? How do you bounce back? Well, it's the same thing in life. When things don't go your way, how do you bounce back from those things? And so it's a lot bigger than just the sport or playing sports. And they're never bigger than the game itself. You have to play with an edge, just like in life, but you're not bigger than the game. And so it was my job, I felt like, as a parent, to kind of humble my boys when they got too big and to encourage them when they didn't have the confidence. So it's a balance of things. As a coach, and there are many of us out there coaching different sports, I would say, just because your style is different, just because I'm not a yeller or a screamer, doesn't mean that I don't have the same expectations. You can get a lot done with individuals just by being unique, just by caring. That doesn't mean the expectations are lowered. It just means that you don't have to yell to always get what you need. And so I just think that's really important for all coaches to hear. There's a way to get the most out of someone. And it's not a canned program. It's not something that everybody's the same. Find out who that individual is as a player, and then work with their strengths and encourage them. You got to be firm at times, but you don't have to yell. Sometimes a strength of a coach is to hold his temper. And I feel like a lot of coaches need to understand that.
Matt Morrow, I'm an instructor here at Morrow's Yard.
Pat Morrow, one of the instructors here at Morrow's Yard. Also coach, assistant coach at Earlham College in Richmond, Indiana.
My name is Mark Chambers. I am one of the full-time instructors.
Hi, my name's Kendall Baker. I'm a baseball, basketball instructor out here at Morrow's Yard.
My name's Macy Gunther. I'm a certified personal trainer through the National Academy of Sports Medicine, and I'm also a hitting instructor here at Morrow's Yard.
Here at the yard, I train anywhere from ages 5 to high school kids, college kids. And what I'm doing is just trying to get them better at all areas of the game, whether that be footwork, hitting, fielding, catching, getting stronger. Just evaluate the guys and just try to get them better as much as possible.
We teach baseball, softball, any type of strength and conditioning, just getting guys prepared for, you know, maybe their travel teams or high schools or colleges. Just trying to get them better in all aspects of their sport in life.
I teach baseball and softball and everything that involves both of those sports.
Baseball and basketball training. So basically we're bringing them through, you know, your basics. And we're working from the ground up based off skill. You know, if you already got some skill, we're going to work through it. But really just the basic stuff, hitting, you know, throwing. We focus a lot on hitting here since we do have the cages. And then basketball, you know, every, you know, your form, your shooting technique, stuff like that. So run them through a lot of drills and techniques to get that down.
I work with athletes on personal training, so we get them developing power and things like that. And I also do softball lessons. I do hitting, fielding, and then as well as doing like some ab workouts and things with some of the younger ones in the weight room.
Sports are important because it teaches you life lessons on and off the field. You know, there's a lot of adversity in sports, and I think that you can learn a lot from it.
Sports are very important as far as, you know, discipline, team building, teamwork, being able to work with other people, you know, different people from different parts of life, and be able to accomplish a goal with that group of people. I think that's what really makes sports different from a lot of different things in life, also preparing you for different parts of life.
Sports are a good tool that will teach a lot of things about life. Teaches persistence and hard work and cooperation and so many things that life involves, and at the same time you get to learn some new skills along the way.
Sports are important. It builds character, it makes you hardworking. I think it builds a lot of relationships. You can build relationships in your community that way. You can build them within your team that way. I would say that's probably one of the biggest things, as well as just building character, making you stronger mentally, physically, things like that. You can push your body to limits that you didn't think you could. And also your mind as well. I know for me, softball really pushed me mentally, just because it's such a mental game. So it really made me grow that confidence in myself and that self-esteem.
Two that stand out to me would be competitiveness. Definitely want to compete, I would say, in the field. Just because, you know, like I said earlier, that there's things that are going to put you down, and when you're competitive, you know, that competitive nature comes out and you don't want to lose. I think that's the biggest thing. And then a learning mentality, I would say, just because you can constantly learn and get better at things all the time, whether it's, you know, from bad examples or good examples, you can always learn from those.
Yeah, definitely hard work and then open-mindedness as far as, you know, being able to adapt to change. If you get stuck in one way, it's hard to adapt and build your skill. Later down the line, different coaches, different teammates, being able to, you know, learn as much as you can what not to do and as well what to do. And that goes, you know, after sports as well, when we're no longer playing, and it adapts, comes with us with life as well.
One of the big things they have to have is the perseverance, because in sports you're going to have many disappointing situations where you fail because of a lack of preparation or something, and you have to be able to know how to pick yourself up and continue to work through your challenges and those frustrating situations, and try to overcome anyhow by any means necessary.
Being able to be coachable is a really big thing. Being able to listen to information, interpret it, and, you know, make it your own technique or whatnot, I think that's the big thing. Being able to be coachable, to be able to have discipline and listen, because that's going to go a long way, you know. Just not in sports, it gets into your jobs and your lifestyle.
I think an athlete should be hardworking, competitive, healthy competitiveness, I think, is really important. Mentally tough, I think that that's something that sports do for you, as well as something that you should have, as well as just being confident in yourself. I think that's really important as well.
I would say have fun with it to start off, because that's important. If you don't have fun, then you know you're never gonna really want to do what you want to do. I would also say hard work. Anything that you do, they can't take it from. And then you get that confidence when you put in that hard work. And it definitely will pay off.
Always set high standards for yourself, not just as an athlete, but as a person. You know, being able to, you know, accomplish those goals. And even if you don't make them, you set the bar so high that you're still able to get somewhere in life. But I would just say set your goals very high, and again, not just as an athlete, but as a person as well, and good things will come.
Give it all you got. I mean, when you have an opportunity to play a sport, it's a blessing that your body is able to do that. So I think just whenever you're out on the field, out on the court, whatever you're doing, give 100% always, just because that's a blessing that you get to do that. Work hard, be the last one in the weight room, first one there, last one off the field, first one there. I think that those things are really important. Just to be a hard worker is probably the number one thing.
I feel like the best advice I could give, if you really are passionate about said sport that you're going after, it's either you're all in or you're all out, really. I feel like if you want to play it, you have to commit to it. It's a day in, day out thing, you know. Everybody else out here is trying to do the same thing as you. Say, you know, basketball, baseball. You have to work at it every single day to get better. So if you want to commit, you have to, you know, be all in or all out.
Never give up. Never give up. Don't let anybody limit you. Don't listen to others' limiting beliefs about you, because they're not you. Okay? Some people may not be very big. Some people may not be very fast. Some people may not be very strong. But you can work through those things if you just continue to work hard. And I always say this to a lot of my students, there is no substitution for hard work.